Hello, everyone. This is part two of our guide to analyze customer feedback with NLP. If you missed the first video, you will find it in the description. If you like it, please share it and hit the subscribe button. In part one, we talk about why it's important to review customer feedback, the difference between data and actionable insights, and how to transform your data into insights. Now we continue with the next topic, which is analyzing customer feedback using NLP. There are a few ways in which companies can make use of NLP technology to analyze their customer feedback. For instance, companies may look at the frequency of words, word grouping, and sentiment analysis. These strategies all fall under the umbrella of text analysis. Let's start with the first one that I have mentioned, which is frequency of words. In the simple version of text analytics, topics or terms are counted, and the tool will surface key topics that are mentioned most frequently. This is pretty common in social media monitoring. For example, if your tool tells that you have the topic customer service and it comes up frequently in your customer feedback, then you'll know that it is a major talking point for your customers. Note that this doesn't let you infer whether your customers are happy or unhappy with your service. It merely tells you that your customers often bring up this specific topic. Word grouping. With word grouping, also known as word pairing, the text analysis tool looks at the different terms that are often occurred all together, so not one per time as before. For example, if you analyze your customer feedback and find that the words costs, affordable, and cheap are typically grouped together, this is a good sign that your customers are saying that your product or service is cost-effective and actually doesn't burn a hole in their wallet. Last, sentiment analysis. So last but not least, text analysis also includes sentiment analysis. As mentioned earlier, this deals with identifying the underlying sentiment of customers and therefore finding how your customers feel about your product or the service. To conduct sentiment analysis, a text analysis tool will look at positive versus negative versus neutral word usage. So, after all, what insights can you generate from using NLP to analyze feedback? The insights that you get largely depend on your input data. For example, if you send out a three-question survey to your customers, asking them about what they like about your product, what they dislike about it, and how they think you can actually improve it, then you will get insights that revolve around these topics. As simple as that. But if you're tapping into customer feedback from product reviews, the insights that you generate might be more open-ended because many customers write lengthy, highly comprehensive reviews. For instance, the insights that you generate from product reviews might deal with customers' pain points, customer needs and wants, your unique selling proposition, USP, which is actually what makes your product stand out and what makes your customers buy from your brand, whether your product lives up with your customers' expectations, what your customers are using your product for, use cases, how your customers are using your product, for example, at which frequency, whether it's used in conjunction with something else, etc. What your customers like and dislike about your product. So now, as promised, I will guide you through some simple steps to collect and analyze customer feedback using NLP. Number one, set up a system to collect customer feedback. If you haven't already done so, go ahead and set up a system or multiple systems that help you collect customer feedback. A common way to collect customer data is surveys. Surveys are not my favorite tool to collect data, but they are quick and easy to set up. So sit down with your team, come up with a list of questions that you'd like to ask, craft a survey, and share the link with your customers. A simple tip, make sure that you're using a neutral language in your survey so that you don't end up influencing your customer in any way. Bias is the biggest problem of survey. Here's a neutral example. How would you describe your experience with the brand number one? And now a negative example. Have you had a bad experience with brand number one? Another way to collect data is through online reviews. As discussed, online reviews are typically data rich, and they tend to be more comprehensive and probably the most comprehensive source of information from consumers. Reviews are also my favorite data source. Bearing this in mind, come up with a strategy to collect as many product reviews as possible. They can be on your independently run website or on third-party platforms such as Amazon. For instance, you could tweak your shipping confirmation email and include a call to action, so-called CTA, that asks for a review. One more source is social media. If you have enabled reviews on your Facebook page, then the reviews that your customers have left you are a great source of feedback also there. But that aside, you can also look at social media posts that bring up your brand. Even if customers are simply posting on their own feeds without tagging you or your company or your products, you would still glean useful insights from these posts. Number two, measure existing customer satisfaction levels. Once you're done collecting customer feedback, don't jump straight into analyzing your feedback. Instead, take some time to measure your existing customer satisfaction levels so that you have a benchmark. If you have already done this in the past quarter, then you can go ahead and skip this step. Number three, organize and interpret data to generate actionable insights. Again, the easiest way to interpret data and analyze a large amount of data is to use an AI-based tool. Once you input your data, NLP tools, like for example Wonderflow that I mentioned before, will use NLP and machine learning to understand your data and identify key insights. If someone has a question such as, what is the most negative topic for this product and is it relevant? The best tools can even draw up data to offer an answer. Number four, come up with an action plan and execute it. So now that you have identified one or multiple actionable insights, the next step is to come up with an action plan based on these insights. Ideally, your action plan should comprise a set of strategies that your customer service team can work on both in the short and in the long term. Once that's done, go ahead and execute the action plan. Otherwise, nothing happens. Number five, track results and measure new customer satisfaction levels. Finally, all that's left to do is to track your key metrics and measure your new customer satisfaction levels. What can happen? If your customers are significantly happier and more satisfied with their brand experience, then congratulations, you're on the right track. If your numbers do not improve or improve only marginally, then take a second look at your insights. Tweak your strategies and try again. Obviously, this was just a very simple list of actions that you can take. Let's say an inspiration to get started. If you want to talk more about solid strategies, just let me know in the comments. I would be happy to talk. And of course, like every time, thanks so much for watching and see you soon.